Okay, today we're going to be replacing a battery, internal battery on one of these Chromebooks. This is an HP 11, as you can see. When you flip it up, normally you'd see it booting up and everything, but this one here, the battery is dead. So, where do they keep this? Some people might think, oh yeah, it's under the keyboard, but no, it's not. Believe it or not, it's under here. It's right here in the front. So, to take this one apart, we go in and you start prying from the back here, and then this pops out there. There we go. And that's part of that. And then you take your Phillips screwdriver and you find a Phillips here. Oh, there it is, it rolled underneath. We'll take these and remember, use your trusty tape to hold down each of your screws. So as you can see here, I'm holding it down with the tape. Okay. So we got a few of these Phillips screws, regular small Phillips screwdriver will work wonders on this one. So after you remove these six screws, there's still two more screws to be taken out here. Because if you don't take out those last two, the back is not coming off. And remember, the battery is up here in the, towards the front. Now, after you take out these six, start peeling away, and you'll need something hard like a this screwdriver here, and you peel this one back and it reveals another screw. There we go. And it's the same size as what's back here. You don't have to worry about that too much. Do the same thing to this side. Again, you pry it open. With a flathead screwdriver, that's one way to do it. Okay. It up. There we go. And then that part, the screw that we need is actually underneath this one right here. Okay, there it is. I don't know if you could see it very well, but there it is. So you had these six, and then these two. Take your Phillips and move the last one of the little burgers there. Okay, and he has to come out. There we go. Now, after you do that, this pops, this should pop free, starting from the hinge, the back portion. This should come out. Get your fingernails in there. There we go. Yeah, comes right out. There's the battery, and here's its replacement. So again, take your Phillips, and you have these screws to remove here. So really I'm only seeing one, two, three, four. Four that have to come out. These are different. Okay, these are different. The different size than what you had before on the back case. So you can put them on a different portion of the tape, different area of the tape, so that you know the difference between the two different types and don't get them mixed up. But guess what? If you get them mixed up, the wrong ones won't go in. It's a different size. There you go, got those four out. Now the battery is almost ready to come out. You just look right here, here's where it's being attached. So, carefully move that one out. That is a small power connection. There you go, see how it came right out. No special things needed there. And let me just look at this here. Are there other things holding this battery in place? Okay, well. There you go. Hey, there it is. This is the old battery. Aren't they small? Look how small and lightweight that is. I mean, that is lightweight. Take that one. Don't let it get mixed up with the new one, because here comes the new one right there. How do you like that, huh? Look at the orientation. See these? These are... Put that in there. Exactly the same way as I keep pulling it out. Only goes in one way, and guess what? Okay, you can't make a mistake on this one. Pack that in, and then, so after you got the screws in and snapped all that in, you go in and reattach. It goes there like that, and then this goes down. So that's pretty easy. Remember, to get into this, you just pop off the foot pegs, take out the six screws here, remove, pop this one open, get the screw here, move it this side, get the screw here. This comes out, and then here's the old battery. It's sitting right in there like that. So, just take that one out and then put in the new one here. Now, this battery says model number SQU-1208. So that's the model number on that one, and this is for an HP 11-inch Chromebook that looks like this. Kind of hard to see it, but yeah. Alrighty. So that's how you replace the battery. Afterwards, make sure that you do charge it up fully overnight, then use it till it gets down to, 15% or so, and then charge it up again overnight, and then deplete it again. Do that three times or so, and you'll have a good battery. Hopefully, a long life for that battery. Okay, thank you very much. Good day.